We've been talking about that as far as we take the road and we start these games off as getting together as a group, whether it's going out for dinners or catching moves, or things, you know, just a little thing to try to build that up court chemistry.
Paul, do you have a way that you're more comfortable being subbed in and subbed out of games, a particular rotation that you like most, or do you feel like you're just the best?
I mean, that's for coach to tinker with. I told him I'm fine with anything. I trust coach 100%, whatever he goes with. He definitely wants the voice of the players and wants the guys to be comfortable with what he's doing. So I'm sure we'll have a back and forth, or I might love whatever he has to do or whatever he has for me. So we'll be good. We'll be good so far.
Do you see an advantage to, you know, with you and Melo and Russ, do you see an advantage to potentially staggering you guys?
Absolutely. I think as much as possible, if he can have either one of us or two of us on the court at all times, it only elevates the team.
Well, you came into a situation in the end where Danny Granger was a guy who had a voice in the locker room, and he was on the other end. How does that transition or timeshare work when, you know, a guy who's been, you know, a big voice in the locker room, you know, eventually kind of cedes some of that responsibility and leadership to another guy?
You see how it works, how it affects the team. And then when you look at the best guy on the team, his voice, you know, what he's been through, that all kind of plays a part into your voice. Now, you say something, you have to own up to it, and you have to be what you're saying. So a lot of that is accountability. And, you see the guys before you. And luxury for me, I've had good vets that kind of led me the way. Show me what it is.
Has Russ made you comfortable in that process, in sort of sharing that load, that responsibility with him?
Yeah, absolutely. Russ has opened his arms, you know, completely, to where myself, Melo, would be very comfortable. It's not our job to try to outshine one another. We're going to do this thing. We got to do it together.
So many new pieces. What's the process of getting everybody speaking kind of the same on-court language in terms of your defensive communication, offensive communication?
Well, I think, you know, you got so many defensive-headed guys on this team, so many defensive-minded guys. All it takes is that ball to get rolled out. We get right after it. Like I stated a couple of days ago, we start out with a defensive mindset, and we start getting after it defensively. Everybody kind of just falls into it. The defensive stance picks up for this team. So I think that's what we want to be. And it looked good first today.
You've been here for a few months now. How do you talk about the city itself, and what you've been able to talk about, the people in the area?
Unbelievable people. Unbelievable as far as the fan support. Just being out downtown, being out in the city in general. The love here, the excitement, I haven't felt this, honestly. We've had a lot of excitement in Indiana, but it's a different thing. Indiana, we had football, we had basketball, we had so many other things going on, to where here, everyone is connected here to basketball. So it's an unbelievable feeling. I can't wait to start and really come out and perform in front of this community.
Hey, Paul, what do you think of when you hear Olympic Melo?
Man, a seasoned vet, and a winner. That's what Melo stands for. Regardless, he's never won that in the NBA. He's still a champion in my eyes, and he's still a winner.
What was it like watching him in some of those, you know, either watching him from afar or being his teammate in those kind of competitions when he's playing with other great players?
Well, he elevated one game. One game, man, if